So let's take a tour of iTunes. iTunes is a really big app that does a lot. So a lot of times people get confused about what it can do and how to navigate it. So a quick tour may help. First thing I'm going to do is look in About iTunes and see that I'm using version 12.6. This is important because iTunes will change over time as new features are added and old features are removed and things like that. So you want to make sure that if you're following this tutorial, you are looking at version 12.6 so you see the same thing. Now, the main control you've got in determining what it is you're looking at in iTunes is this pop-up menu right here. And this is how you switch between different sections of iTunes. Each one is almost kind of its own app. So the first one here I've got is music, and this is how I view the music in my library. And I can view it here using items in the sidebar. So I can look at recently added, look by artist, look by album, song, genres. Different ways of viewing the same content. Now you also have these buttons here at the top. For You and Browse refer to Apple Music. Library refers to the stuff that you've got in your library. So if you're not using Apple Music, Library is where you're going to go for actually viewing the stuff that you've got. You also have Store over here, which goes to the iTunes Music Store, which is where you can purchase music from Apple. Now, if you switch away from music, you can go to other subjects that are similar, like movies and TV shows. And these will also show your library, the things that you've got available here, and you have the store where you can download or, in the case of movies, rent movies as well. And you can view movies, you can view by genre as well. So you've got that. You can also go to apps. Now apps is a little confusing because that has nothing to do with Mac apps. Since iTunes is the way that you connect your iPhone or iPad to your Mac, then these apps have to do with apps on that device. And a lot of us don't even use this section anymore. You can have a library of all of your apps, backups of them, but it's not really necessary to do this anymore. It was kind of in the early days. But you also can go to the App Store here, which will load in the iOS App Store. So you can kind of review apps available for your iPhone and iPad here. And if you're still syncing with your Mac and not using iCloud, then you can download them to your Mac first and then move them over to your iPhone or iPad. But I don't think most people do this nowadays. So apps is kind of outdated there. You've got ringtones, which you also use to create ringtones that then get synced to your iOS devices. And then you've got other things like internet radio. As a matter of fact, you can go to Edit menu here and there's a whole bunch of different things you can add. For instance, you can go podcasts, iTunes U, audiobooks, which are audiobooks you purchase through iTunes. And once you add them all, they're all available in this menu here. So for instance, I could go over to podcasts and here I could search for podcasts, I could download podcasts, things like that. It's all, again, it's like a whole other app that just deals with podcasts inside of iTunes. If you think of these each as a different app, then it makes a lot more sense. So that's the basics there. You've got your playback controls at the top, mostly for music, but playback controls for movies will also look similar to that. If we go to music here, also notice that we've got these under the sidebar here playlists that you create. People like to create playlists of their music for different things. And also under devices you can see my iPad. And next to this pop-up menu here is this little control because my iPad is connected. It shows a tiny iPad icon. It would show an iPhone icon if my iPhone were connected. If both were connected, it would show both of them. And I can actually click on that and it would switch to yet another mode for iTunes, which shows my iPad all sorts of different information about it in the left sidebar and here in the middle. I can switch to manually sync things between my Mac and my iPad or iPhone. Again, a lot of people today just use iCloud like I do and they don't really even hook up their device to their Mac much anymore. But you can certainly do this for backups. It's useful to backup locally as well as to iCloud. So when I've switched over here to view my iPad, I've got this Backup Now button here. And actually it shows me that it's been recently backed up to iCloud, so I'm good there. But it's been a long time since I've backed up this iPad to this computer, so it might be good to have a second backup. So I may hit Backup Now to backup the iPad here. To get out of this mode, you can use this back button. You've got these forward and back buttons just like in the browser. So as you navigate through here, if you're not sure how to get back to where you just were, you can use this back button here. So that's the basics of navigating around iTunes. Think of it as a collection of different apps that has to do with media on your computer and connectivity to your iPhone and iPad. and take the time to explore it, because it can do a lot and it could perform some useful functions for you, particularly in playing music, playing media, renting movies on your Mac, and a few other things like podcasts and such.